The quote, combined forces of the U.S. private and public sectors will be necessary to protect American democracy from interference in what he calls an arms race. Now, Twitter's Jack Dorsey will face a second round of questioning, this second one solo before the House Energy and Commerce Committee on the topic of bias in Twitter's content monitoring. In prepared remarks, Dorsey is saying Twitter, quote, does not use political ideology to make any decisions. Now, Google will be noticeably absent today. The Senate committee invited Alphabet CEO Larry Page and rejected Google's offer to send its top legal and policy exec, Kent Walker. Andrew, back over to you.
Hey, thank you, Julia. Stick around, because joining us right now, Democratic Caucus Chief Deputy Whip, Congressman Peter Welch is joining us, and Congressman Bill Johnson. They both serve on the Energy and Commerce Committees. Good morning to both of you.
Good morning.
Let me ask you this, and Senator Welch, I'll ask you first. Do you think, when you look at Twitter right now, that there is a political bias to the way they have approached things?
Well, it's a fair question. And the bottom line here is that whether that's raised by Democrats or President Trump, you do need an answer to it. Are the algorithms favoring one side versus the other? And the bottom line here is that Twitter and these huge operations like Facebook have to do a lot more, be transparent, be protective of what does go on, keep hate speech off it. But Congress hasn't stepped up. I mean, we essentially have a regulatory system that was designed for when we had dial-up phones. So I think there's a lot of work that we have to do in Congress to make certain that the rights of citizens and the integrity of our political process is protected. And we have to also put a lot of demands on Twitter and Facebook and these other big operations.
Congressman Johnson, I understand that you are concerned about what may seem like a bias. The question, of course, is if that is true, first of all, which you have to decide on or stipulate, what do you do about it? And do you regulate these companies?
Well, you know, I've never been a big fan of more government regulations. I believe in a small or limited government. I think the fact that we have Twitter and Facebook and Google and other such applications is because the federal government has not been able to regulate them or has not been able to figure out how to regulate them. However, in the absence of regulation, the responsibility, the bar for responsibility by these tech companies is very, very important. The bar is higher. And to fall back on the assertion that these are algorithmic decisions that are being made, that's a tech term that goes right over the heads of many people. Algorithms are written by people. They are conditionally based logic statements that say, if this, then do this. And we tell the computer system what to do. And so someone is making the decisions about content.
Right.
And that's what we want to find out today from Mr. Dorsey.
Congressman Johnson, though, what happens if we just decided that rather than call them a platform, call them a media company? And to the extent that there's commentary and analysis that's done on all sorts of media that has all sorts of biases, we've had this conversation before, I imagine you wouldn't necessarily regulate a media company.
Well, and I think that's a very, very good question, because 93% of the American people say that they get their news online. Two-thirds of the American people say that they get it through some type of social media platform like Twitter or Facebook or others. And so I think that's a very good question. I think for a tech company to assert that they're just a tech company, I don't think that that's accurate. I think they are, to a degree, a media company, and the American people deserve credibility and integrity in making sure that what they think they're seeing is accurate and true.
Julia Borson's got a question for you, gentlemen.
No, in Jack Dorsey's prepared remarks, he says repeatedly that there's no bias in the way the algorithm works and the decisions they make. With that in mind, and having taken a look at his prepared remarks, Congressman Welch, what do you think the most important thing is that you want to hear from Dorsey today?
Well, how do you verify that? I mean, what you've seen on some of these platforms, and it something probably makes much more sense to talk about, is really totally false and defamatory information. I mean, the biggest example, of course, is the attacks on parents who lost their children at Newtown. And, you know, the First Amendment protects free speech, but it doesn't protect yelling fire in a crowded theater. So there's got to be some way where when there's a legitimate question raised, whether it's by Bill Johnson or President Trump or the Democrats, that you can get to the bottom of it and do it quickly in a transparent way. So we are moving, I think, towards an area where Congress has to ask the question whether we need some regulatory body that is empowered, whether it's the FCC or FTC. Well, that's the question, because it would have to have that flexibility that Mr. Johnson is talking about, but you'd have to be able to have an action that would protect, say, the Newtown parents from these attacks that are just flat out, we all agree, totally false, defamatory, and very destructive. And Congress hasn't even asked that question itself on the Energy and Commerce Committee. But I do think this question of whether you need some regulatory body that is going to be able to protect the integrity of some of this information, or certainly keep off hate speech and keep off clearly false speech, like what has happened to the Newtown parents. It's time for Congress, I think, to step up and answer that question. What's the regulatory body that will answer these
Congressman
questions?
Congressman Johnson, I know you say you're concerned about regulation, but you heard what President Trump has had to say on this issue, and a number of your colleagues on the right have made similar comments about the need for regulation. What do you make of that idea?
Well, I'm not saying that there's not a need for regulation. I'm saying we have to be very careful about pouring water on our campfire. You know, that's what has happened to America's economy since the early 70s. The growth of big government has put such regulation on the backs of businesses that it has stifled innovation and ingenuity in many sectors. Information technology and the internet is one area where regulations have been absent. And so it has thrived, and we've got the digitally connected world that we do today. So I'm not saying that it's not any regulation or no regulation. I'm saying we got to be very, very careful about how we do this so that we don't put on the brakes of innovation. We're the technology leader in the world, and we want to maintain that position at the head of the table in the global economy.
Congressman, both of you, thank you for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
That in this whole conversation, almost the roles have been reversed. Republicans who historically didn't like regulation, now all of a sudden talking about regulation. Democrats who historically wanted regulation, now saying maybe they don't like regulation because basically the president likes regulation. I mean, it's